Hello, everyone. I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. This is Sister Mary. I'm going to bring you two words received today, Friday, October the 20th, 2017. It is amazing how the Holy Spirit can speak to us in real timing and let us know things that are about to occur. I know that things are going to rapidly unfold. I will continue, and as you'll hear these messages, I'm going to continue to do what the Lord has appointed at this time for me to do, as well as other people that are sharing dreams and visions and messages from the Holy Spirit. So again, all prophecy is the testimony of Jesus Christ. If you're watching this YouTube channel for the first time, you are hearing a prophetic word received through the Holy Spirit. Anybody can receive messages. The Holy Spirit tells us how you hear. He tells you how you are given this ministry. So I'm going to read this message. There's two messages, and I'll tell you when the next one starts. But the Holy Spirit spoke for, I'm going to say, well over an hour and a half. So God bless you as you listen. And I wasn't going to put it on tonight because it's Friday. It's already getting late. All of us have had a long day, or I have. But I feel like, because tomorrow is the beginning of the weekend, there are things that I am going to speak in this message that I know in the morning there is new purpose to get up and to get a lot done. So God bless you. I know that this word is for many people, not just me. In parts of it, you will hear where the Holy Spirit was speaking directly to me, but I am sharing with you because I know that the Lord has been speaking to many of my brothers and sisters. And if He is speaking to you in this time, it is an appointed time, it is an appointed hour that He is speaking, and you have a job to do. So don't let things detour you. Don't let Satan put things in front of you that keep you away from fulfilling what God has appointed you to do. So, the first thing that the Lord said today was many horrible things are coming upon this world. And we know that. Every day, there's something different. I didn't even watch news tonight. He says, do you trust me wholeheartedly? I am your sovereign King and Lord. I love all that are mine. I am coming to wrap things up. Evil runs wild in the imaginations of the wicked. Evil has man become. But wait, I surely tell you this day, evil that is present now will grow far, far worse than you can imagine. I haven't given you dreams or messages of elderly loved ones. This is in my house. Being left in a state they can't escape. I have shown you, this is him speaking to me, and maybe to you too, but I've been shown, and he says, I have shown you some of what will come to pass, because I knew you would be faithful and true right up to the trumpet blast. We are so close to the Lord coming to take the church, the true body that seeks him, that loves him, that does the will of the Father. He says, I have asked you to do certain things, getting your house clean. And he does mean cleaned out because I've shared this before. This is two houses that are joined together. And there are lots of things that I have that there's no way I can use all of it. So he's saying, go ahead and get all of that cleaned out. Because what will life be like for those left behind to find that they had to go through so many things that belong to you? This will be a time of horrific sorrow for them, the pain almost seemingly oh too much to bear. You, my child, my dearest one, you do not stay. If the Lord has been speaking to you about doing certain things, there is a reason. You will not continue on. You will be transformed in the twinkling of an eye at the sound of my trumpet blast. You must take all seriously, all that I have spoken, and a little more to come, meaning that a little bit more is going to be given. I am not finished using you, my faithful servant, yet. Stay close to me, stay still for the moment. Don't put yourself in any situation of change. And you just have to know that I have been thinking about going back to my old job where I was driving all over my area, delivering medical supplies. And the Lord has said, no, you stay where I have placed you because I've put you there for a reason. Pretty much because I'm close to home. He says, you know what you're able to do right now. Stand firm and grounded in my holy words. Your testimony will reveal truth. It will all come to pass. This is a reminder from the Holy Spirit that he has told me to go back and to listen to the previous videos because messages that I've been given, I need to write them down and make sure that I continue to share what it's supposed to be or what I've been given. Hold fast, my child, to what has been given. But at last, do as I have instructed. You have prepared, but continue. Don't stop now. The rush of a mighty wind doeth blow over your land. Continue and be steadfast. I am coming sooner than most think. It will happen in a single blink. Upon, mind you, the brink of much destruction. Do not worry one moment about your children, your husband, or your in-laws. I know what it will take to break the will of all men. You have been chosen for this appointed time. I will continue to call you deeper into a highest calling. I have placed ministering angels around you. Your nation will soon be falling. You will continue to warn, for many will be in great shock and panic. You will not see the fruit of your labor here, but believe me, my dear, with great cheer. Your ministry that I have placed on you will cover many. They will believe and be able to stand in faith in me without wavering, without any doubt, by the testimony of your spoken words. A prophetic ministry have I placed upon you. Speak unto all who will listen. As your nation falls, I will call many faithful servants, yea, chosen from the beginning of all creation, to their eternal home, my resting place. Will you stay? My resting place, will you stay? While so many left behind will endure much death and destruction, will they see with their seeing eyes? And they who were once called shall turn from their sinful ways back to me. Speak these words as a reminder to all. If I have recently, in the past few months, spoken to your heart, and you feel like you're not going to be here much longer, it's because I am calling you home. But have and leave everything in order. This is vitally important. You have family and friends that you continue to warn, but you see no change. Rest knowing you are doing all that I have asked. I request this final thing. Leave all areas of your life clean, without spot or blemish nor wrinkle. Many of you have reconciled any harbored feelings. Now reconcile all in leaving your living legacy behind. Write letters of encouragement. Tell all it's not too late to be worthy to escape the day of destruction. I shall come again to this earth. I will put a final end to all the hurt, all the pain that Satan has caused. Trust in me in all manner, in every step you take. I am guiding and leading you all home, to your eternal home. Time is of the essence. You must go through your possessions. As you pack and haul off many personal items not needed for anyone left behind, look at exactly what and how much of you remains in each room of your homes. I want you to keep stuff, but so many of you need to rid. Go through all your stuff to minimize the pain. Leave nothing undone. Tell your family often how you love them, and tell them how much I love them. And be done. Be done. Settle all that I have spoken to you in your hearts. I am taking whom I wish now. I am taking you in some families, one at a time. Leave everything simply reflecting the love you had for me and your family. My children, you are all so very precious unto me. You who have been faithful through and through, seeing how the world has rapidly changed, I am taking you now out of harm's way. Each day is darker, and you are in even more danger than the day before. Go and do what I have instructed. Notice how your family doesn't sense what I've placed in your heart. You are mine, solely, solely mine, and I am all thine. You will be with your Savior and Master forevermore. There is great wonder for you all in store. You have stored treasures and blessings in heaven. Some of you do not understand why I do not take all at one time. You don't know what I know. You haven't seen all that I see. Some of you have warned your children, your families, and friends of the dangers that are ever so near, trying as you may scare them into loving me. But I tell you this one thing. I know for sure they simply will not believe until you leave and they find themselves left behind. They will have even greater faith than to believe. Much sin remains. While you have my light, I see you as a light bearer, shining light, wherever you go, showing and leading others to the gate. They must enter in, but it's so narrow, the road you're on. They are continuing along the path that leads to death and destruction. Continue to cover your children with much prayer. They need it. I hear your pleas. I see your tears. And oh, the many tears you've shed, trying your best to convince them of one thing that they must change to enter in. I am showing mercy to your lost loved ones. While they will not escape as you will, they will find me and enter heaven for eternity. But only after suffering can they truly seek forgiveness from their risen King. Anyone who calls upon my name before the day of destruction will be granted permission to enter into heaven, heaven's pearly gates. You will not wait much longer. I will endue you with much power and strength till I call you home to be with your King. You will not feel death's sting. You instead are hidden and protected underneath my wings. Time is no longer. The minutes are passing quickly. Remain faithful and true. But do now all I've told you to do. For by not doing so now places your loved ones left behind in a most hurtful position. Some of you are the very glue that holds your entire family together. You are truly cherished. But you know who you are. You love me more than anyone or anything on this earth, and that is what has made you worthy, my dearest abiding children, your loving King Yeshua. And when I turned on the radio after the message received, both messages received, it is Chris Tomlin home. So I'm going to bring you the second word, and then I'm going to try to play some of that song very quickly. The tribulation is a time like no other. It affects everyone left behind. It is a time of unprecedented horrors, one calamity after another. Food shortages, much death due to hunger, plagues and sicknesses. No cures, no medicines to take pain away. It's like conditions of a third world country. Sickness, a time of incurable disease. Terror on every corner. Large cities will become like zombies. People will take this mark, but it's not a mark of ease and living on easy street. Do you not know the devil is a thief? He comes only to kill, steal, and destroy. People taking the mark are not found in the Lamb's Book of Life. They chose this life to their delight. For the hours given here, it will never compare to what I prepared for them in heaven. Weeping and gnashing of teeth will be forever, for all eternity. Turn to me, ye wicked sinner. No, I sincerely say to you this very day, not one earthly pleasure is worth separation, eternal separation from me, your risen King. Those that continue in sinful ways without repentance will see me, but then will hear, depart from me, ye evildoer. All evildoers shall burn, weep, and wail in the lake of fire, raging forever in hell. For these words are spoken unto thee. The wages of sin is death, and this is eternal separation from me, your Creator and King. I am the Alpha and Omega, beginning and end of all creation and all things. Will you seek me on bended knee? Kneel before your King, before you feel my wrath and the sting that death in sin will surely bring. And that was it. I'm going to very quickly pull up, as fast as I can, guys, the song that I was listening to. And it is Chris Tomlin, Home. And it is beautiful. Well, now I downloaded it, so it's just quicker to go to Chris Tomlin going home. It's late, guys. I apologize. But some of you got work to do in the morning. Here's the song. Let me see if I can get it a little bigger for you.
This world is not what it was meant.